Hi, VencoreWeather.com meteorologist Paul Dorian here on Monday, April 30th, the last day of the month of April. We have a major warm-up coming to the Mid-Atlantic region. Really gets well underway on Tuesday afternoon, and it peaks in the Wednesday, Thursday, Friday time frame. Probably Thursday afternoon will be the warmest temperatures, perhaps up to 20 degrees above normal for a change here in the Mid-Atlantic region by the time Thursday afternoon rolls around. So again, a big warm-up. Begins Tuesday, continues on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. There may be a cool frontal passage late in the day Friday or Friday night with some shower and thunderstorm activity, and then a bit cooler again this weekend. Well, the tornado season so far has been well below normal for this time of the year. In fact, we talked about this last week. The state of Oklahoma has not seen a single tornado yet this calendar year. That is the latest for the first tornado ever. It already broke the record of April 26, 1962, which coincidentally was kind of a similar year to this year in that March and April were way below normal temperature-wise in much of the eastern half of the nation, as was the case this year. And that basically inhibited any kind of a hot, humid air mass flowing northward from the Gulf of Mexico, which is kind of a key ingredient for tornadoes. Here's where we stand right now in terms of tornado season so far. 230 have been reported, which is actually a bit below the 25th percentile ranking for this time of the year. Having said that, this looks like an active week, especially in the Wednesday, Thursday time frame for the middle of the country. They very likely will see their first tornado of the year in the state of Oklahoma, and many tornadoes could form this week in the Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday time frame, but especially focused on Wednesday across the Central Plain. So far, well below normal, but again, we'll have to watch for quite a bit of activity, it looks like, this week as we begin the month of May on Tuesday. Well, one last look before we take a look at the local weather situation. This is the Storm Prediction Center forecast for Wednesday in terms of the probability of severe weather, and they already have an enhanced region right through the heart of the country here across Oklahoma and from Texas all the way up to Kansas and Nebraska. And that's very impressive when you're a few days ahead of the event, and the Storm Prediction Center centered out there in Norman, Oklahoma, already has an enhanced prediction here for severe weather possibilities on Wednesday. And again, we'll focus in on the reasons why over the next couple of minutes as we look at the local weather conditions as well. Well, let's take a look at the forecast maps from last night's 6E GFS model run. First, we'll look at 500 millibar height anomalies, and we'll walk through in six-hour increments all of these maps from tropicaltidbits.com. Let's just first start off here in the northeast U.S. This morning, we have a vigorous upper-level low causing some clouds from around Philadelphia north and east. And in fact, there could be some sprinkles, light showers rotating around this vigorous upper-level low. It's still cooler than normal here in the northeast U.S. as we begin the new work week and end the month of May. But again, there can be a light shower at any time in New York City over the next several hours, maybe even down to Philadelphia. Washington, D.C. probably in the clear in terms of the clouds and a light rainfall over the next few hours, mostly sunny skies south of the Mason-Dixon line. Notice strong ridging popping up here over the middle part of the country, and yet there's another upper-level feature, an upper-level low out in the western U.S. Now, let's move forward here in time. Here we are by this evening. That upper-level low over the northeast U.S. finally starting to push away, and here we go. Some ridging showing up here, indicated by the oranges on this 500 millibar height anomaly forecast map for Tuesday morning. Also, vigorous upper-level low cutting across the southwestern states over the next few days. So we warm up here, noticeably warmer on Tuesday, well up in the 70s in D.C., Philadelphia, New York City, after a still below-normal day on Monday to start the work week. And here we go. Look at this clash starting to set up out here in the Central Plains, the eastern part of the Rockies. This is now Tuesday night. Let's go into Wednesday afternoon. Strong upper-level ridging centered right over the eastern U.S. 80s likely here Wednesday, Thursday, into Friday in D.C., Philadelphia, New York City. But a strong upper-level low slowly grinding its way through the southwestern U.S., setting up quite a clash here in the Central Plains and places like Texas, Oklahoma, Kansas, and Nebraska can see some severe weather in this time period of Wednesday, Thursday, including the threat, unfortunately, for tornadoes. So yes, tornadoes have been way below normal for this time of the year, but it looks like an active period. It seems like as soon as we change the map on the calendar from April to May, we increase the severe weather, and that's coinciding with this clash that will form here in the middle part of the country by the middle part of the week. Let's keep moving forward here, and here we go into Thursday. Still an active look to it out in the Central Plains. Still very, very warm here over the northeast U.S., and that ridge holds on right through the end of the work week. And again, there can be a little bit of a cold frontal passage coming here Friday night, maybe with some showers and thunderstorms in the I-95 corridor, and a bit cooler for Saturday, but certainly nice for this time of the year, but not quite as warm as it will get here on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Well, let's take a look at the surface maps from last night, 6E GFS model run. Again, upper level low spinning over New England, causing some snow up in the Catskills this morning. Quite amazingly, seeing some snow even this morning, the last day of the month of April, up over the Catskills, for example, southeastern New York, across northeastern Pennsylvania, even in some of those higher elevations, you could see some flurries. And here we go. Light sprinkles, light showers can extend all the way down to Philadelphia, New York City, central New Jersey over the next few hours. Lots of clouds, still cooler than normal. South of the Mason-Dixon line, you're safe. Mostly sunny skies and no threat of rain south of the Mason-Dixon line. Let's now move forward here into Tuesday morning. High pressure starts off the day here in the eastern U.S., but watch what it does. It pulls off the coast by later tomorrow. That opens the door for southwesterly flow to form in the lower levels of the atmosphere on the western side of that high. Much milder air pouring into the Great Lakes and Ohio Valley later tomorrow. And in fact, some of that will work its way into the I-95 corridor region. Again, the 70s. Quite likely for highs in D.C., Philadelphia, New York City on Tuesday afternoon. Maybe even a flirtation with the 80-degree mark in the D.C. metro region tomorrow afternoon. Let's keep moving forward here. Wednesday morning, lots of southerly flow here. One thing we talked about up front, the lack of Gulf of Mexico air, which is kind of a necessary requirement for severe weather this time of the year in the south central part of the nation, the Central Plains. Look at this, high pressure here, low pressure here, the wind flow between the two, right out of the Gulf of Mexico come Wednesday morning, setting the stage for a possible widespread outbreak of severe weather in Texas, Oklahoma, Kansas, and Nebraska. Let's move forward here, and continuation of southwesterly flow here in the Mid-Atlantic region. Cold air over the Rockies, again, that perfect setup of cold air moving in from the Rockies, even some snow here represented by the blues, blue color here, and very warm and humid air pumping northward from the Gulf of Mexico into the south central U.S. Again, watch out for severe weather on Wednesday afternoon. Still, vigorous westerly flow of air here as we move into Thursday in the Mid-Atlantic region. Still the threat for some severe weather out in the middle of the nation on Thursday. And here we go. A little cold frontal system starting to show up here on the maps by Friday morning. That could throw some showers and thunderstorms into the I-95 corridor later in the day on Friday into Friday night as we move forward. Not a heavy rain event, but it could turn things a little bit cooler as we begin the weekend. Let's now get into Saturday morning. Again, it looks like a decent start to the weekend, but it may be 5 to 10 degrees cooler on Saturday than it will be on Friday. So again, the highlights of the week, a major warm-up coming to the Mid-Atlantic region, including D.C., Philadelphia, New York City, really gets underway in earnest on Tuesday, but peaks Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday with high temperatures in the 80s and a severe weather outbreak possible this week in the Central Plains, especially focused on Wednesday, maybe even spilling over into Thursday as well. That's it for now. For VencoreWeather.com, I'm meteorologist Paul Dorian.